Good to meet you, man.
From the first handshake with Frank Hill, you know he's not normal. He wears a button that says so. And Frank doesn't hesitate to tell you his title.
They call me the Manure Man of South Carolina.
Frank is the Manure Man because of what he's wearing around his neck, a necklace made with a bird dropping.
Now, this is the only article on the market today that's guaranteed to be a bunch of crap to start with.
Frank Hill is the creator of a glittering assortment of quail drop rings, necklaces, and tie tacks. And Frank is living proof that if you just be yourself, you can find fame and fortune.
Good morning, workers.
Every morning, Frank and his workers get down to business.
Yeah, quite a disgusting job, Frank.
Yeah. Well, I tell you, really and truly, my friends up north used to lay a bunch of crap on me, and I figured one day if I could come up with something that would outdo them, it'd be good for joke, but when my Yankee friends started buying these things as fast as I could hand them out, I thought I done got a hope of something good. When an old Southern boy can sell a Yankee a pile of crap no bigger than that there for $10, I said, he done something great, you know.
Well, the Yankees do buy this stuff. This letter from Massachusetts is one of the many addressed to the doo-doo company. Frank makes his jewelry in a cluttered room in his barn. He carefully pours liquid plastic into a mold and covers each dropping.
I have made a lot of money out of it, but it sure has got opened a lot of doors for me, and I met a lot of nice people just on account of the crap.
Hey, you boys better hold on, because I'm going to have to stand on it.
It sure has opened doors. After being on Johnny Carson, Burt Reynolds saw Frank and put him in two movies.
What are you doing now, Dad?
Oh, I make jewelry.
Oh, that's just real pretty, isn't it? What do you make it out of?
Organic matter, manure.
Kind of makes you the Cartier of caca.
They told me to be myself, but that wasn't enough acting, you know, and I don't know how to act.
Of course, Frank wasn't quite himself in the film because he wore a toupee.
In the wintertime, that thing feels good. I forget which way it goes.
But even better than a toupee, Frank says, was working with Lonnie Anderson.
She was a nice lady, you know, and I was so afraid I was going to smell bad when I was around her. You know, I used a double dose of stuff and under my arms and all. I won't be smelling like no crap around that because there ain't no crap to that.
Not many people go from a textile town to tinsel town, but Frank Hill did, thanks to his imagination. Frank's even got his own plane now in his garage. As he takes off to go fishing, Frank says we can learn a great lesson about life from his droppings.
You just do the best you can with what you got, no matter what it is, and it'll come out good in the end. It did for me.